भक्त कार्यैक देहाया नमस्ते सदा।
Today we've got a few people to speak about David's journey. We all know and understand it was an amazing event.
One of Dave's most unique qualities was to see in people things they didn't necessarily see in themselves. That led to his uncanny ability to get the best out of people, particularly as guides. Dave was a humanitarian. He couldn't have taken the photographs he did unless he had a deep empathy with the people he was photographing. I decided that in David's heaven, it's always a big water Krenali trip, fully booked with people who never think to compare notes on what they paid. David's heaven, there are no cars or walking tractors in Kathmandu. Nobody burns plastic. The carpet shops all have good carpets and they don't know what they're worth. There are no worms in the Sanji in Mugli. In fact, in David's heaven, there is no Mugli.
Ravi's an extremely eloquent man, but the rough trip really doesn't go like that. Most of those things that happen in David's heaven don't happen when you're on the river. They do tends to be the opposite. But that was a trip of about 50 people. I think there were about 10 rafts.
To be truly challenging, a voyage like a life must rest on a firm foundation of financial unrest. Otherwise, you are doomed to a routine traverse, the kind known to yachtsmen who play with their boats at sea. Cruising, it is called. Voyages belong to seamen and to the wanderers of the world who cannot or will not fit in. Bankruptcy of purse or bankruptcy of life. Sterling Hayden. And I truly believe this influenced the way David lived his life.
The thing that made my dad wonderful, when I wasn't there, he made me laugh with his funny nose and his big red nose. He always played with me and Honeybee. Everything made the best dad in the world, and I loved him so much.
Well, you may have to let me cry, Georgie. Okay. It's not the age that you live to that counts. How much you fit into your life, that's important. By this standard, I think my father, David Henry Allardice, lived a very full life.
The 20th anniversary of the raft encounter at the pool was 5 years ago. Perhaps the most surprising thing about this trip was myself. Somehow, Dad had managed to convince my mum it was a good idea to let their 15-year-old son go down a class 5 river with a raft dedicated to alcohol and a bunch of Dad's old drinking buddies. I don't know how he slipped that one underneath the nose, but I'm so glad he did. In those 3 weeks in Nepal, I had some of the best times of my life. As a plus, it was with my father that they happened. So I think that's it. Thank you all for coming.
Yeah, that's pretty good. That's pretty good.
Come and spend a bit of time with the man.
I cannot open, she broken.